Welcome to the video. The Conjuring season's just about to end, so I'm going to use all my tickets to see if I can pull any good monsters, like Ancestors or the new Abyssal ones that you can't get from anywhere else apart from the Conjuring gate. I've got 4.6k. There's some changes coming to the Conjuring Gacha where you can Abyssals from the general gate, and you'll be getting tickets for the general gate and the daily challenges and the legends pass. And they're also going to increase the statistics and the likelihood that you'll get one of the Abyssal monsters. I had to spend some gems in the bounty store to get some stamina to reach the last step of the challenge to get 370 more tickets. So I'm going to use those as well on top. So let's get into these summons. My first four. Some legends and some mythics. Hyperia, who I've not ranked, has one of the highest gold productions of every legend. I think it might even be the highest gold production. And that's 100 sales of that. So I can rank that up. Some more Shadowina added on top of the ones that I've got above rank 5. And I've not got Armor Claw to rank 3, past rank 3 yet. And Chuckle Muckle. I was kind of trying to work on back in the day, but I kind of got sidetracked by other monsters. And I think that's me able to craft that monster now. Hydratilla the Icebringer, but I don't know. I might already have it. So let's get into this next block of sun. Twenty Robur Odin shield cells. It's got damage mirror. I've heard it's not got the best skills, and it's one of the ancestral monsters that I know least about. Some Beambot cells, which would be a good pull for anyone that doesn't have it maxed, because it can hold Revival Essence, so Shadowina's Essence as well as being light. Well, I froze that one. Pretty easy to rank up in the dungeon as well, since it can revive itself. So let's get another block of summons on the go. More Hydratillas seem to be getting a lot of nemesises here. Yeah, the Riftmaker and this Hydratilla one seems to be coming up quite a lot, or just all the Hydratillas. Firecatcher is a good one for the bounty hunt. If you've got Serpentex, it can apply fire weakness and light weakness. Time for another summon. Pulled Robur Odin shield. No way, sweet. So my first ancestral monster. Earth and Nature. So that's pretty dope. 100 Syntheris cells as well. A healing taunt from the Metropolitan era. So Robur Odin shield has got Shield Slam, it is Damage Mirror. So read over a little bit about Robur Odin shield there, and it's not got many pros, it's got a lot more cons, but as an Abyssal monster it's going to have high stats, and it'll be cool, it'll sit in a little habit. It'll look good in my profile and stuff, so it's going to be earning more gold than all the other one. So now to get in for another summon. In fact, thinking about it, I'm going to actually go and hatch my ancestral monster. Not hatch, but put in the hatchery. So here's another 5 summons coming up. So some Marchinian cells, but a lot of those cells from the original bounty hunt that came with. Garal Brutalis, which I've not got a max rank yet. Got it from the race. I talked about it a bit in my last video. It's got the taunt trait, but it has to set up Megaton with a skill. So people used to use 2x life on it and an x speed, which was weird to see on a tank back in the day. And Chuckle Muckle, more towards ranking that up. For book rewards even. And the Keeper. Pretty cool legend. The owner of the library. So some legends there, and some other mythics, an original generation one, Urkan, same design basically as Zero Zone, put that in my last Conjuring video. So 100 Iguanosaur cells, and that's over a breakout now for that monster, and 40 Wormlad cells, don't think I've got that rank 5. So 5 more summons. So some Mother Talica cells. And Tartalion's one I was going to maybe rank up. Because it would be good for a B team, War, or C team. It's got the Thorn trait and it can hold Shadowina's essence. So if you have a team of 3 essence holders and they're all max Shadowina's essences, that's added hundreds of thousands of dark damage on top. And the strength increase, which I'd forgotten about. So the Keeper, if you ever want to see a funny video in Monster Legend, or not funny but like obscure, hit up the library, click on the information thing. I might as well play it just now in this video. Oh no, in fact it opens YouTube. I probably shouldn't watch that. Did I just close Monster Legend? So aside from that, I thought I would have broken my luck streak there if that. I thought I'd accidentally closed Monster Legend. I'll just get back to the Conjuring. I can't remember what that video was all about. I just remember it being random. I've got some general gate tickets as well to use after this. Now for one of my last summons. So some old mythics and some legends. Was just checking there if Cloud had a high gold production, but just average. So 3 more blocks at times 5. Nice one, I got Woper down. It can apply area dodge and evasion to itself. And it's got Sandstorm, so it can block here. And Roots, so a good control that not many people are immune to. And Reverse Healing, so any shields or armors you've got that's got healing properties, Operdinger can use that to counter you. And some more Nemesis here. Hydra Tiller. Gonna have some high ranked Hydra Tillers after these. There's a new event coming that's like a Colosseum thing. I saw a post about it. I could maybe put it on the screen or something just now. Gonna do another summon just now. So here we go. Two more sent to the cells. And some helium cells. I just remembered I should probably put Wolperdinger on the hatchery. Gonna do that just now. And I just remembered I can level up my Thunder Beast once I get this next rank 5 Metro Monster. And I've got 3 pods, so I'm gonna do it just now. And I've got an even number of gems, which is good for the end of the season. Not started ranking up Alchemist yet. But looks like I'm gonna have quite a high rank one. I beat it a lot of times in live duels, though it doesn't seem that good. But I can stun and give toxin or something. Don't know about the toxin. So I would save these breakouts normally for Wraiths. And I've got a lot of them. Even the Voltaic one I've been saving for like a video or something. But I'm gonna do this just now to get that Thunder Beast maxed. And that'll be in a video. I use the Thunder Beast on my defense team. But just now it's only level 5. So I should probably show you the level 6 perk for it. So at level 6, the strength boost doesn't go up. Applies true vision to your thunder and metal allies, so their attacks will always hit. 100% accuracy increase. Now I'm going to put a Wolperdinger on the hatchery. So that's what's on the hatchery just now. Got one more block out. Times 5. So some legends and some more leafling cells. So that's progress towards ranking leafling. And any tickets you've got there are going to be transported into the regular conjuring gate. So Nahin for my second last summon. And 2 times Nahin. I think Nahin does possession or something. So now I've got 3 times 5 summons there, and that'll be the end of the conjuring season. So some Akuno Bookie sales. Trying to get that to rank 5. Or not one that I've ranked up. And that can hold Revival Essence as well. So, a Shadowing Ascension. And do some healing. And Grakon's one that's dynamite. So, always good to rank 5 that one. If you get sales of it. And I don't think I had Wartak the Skull Crusher. I can check if I had it before by exiting and if I've got a pop up. So to a new nemesis egg, which is always good for the collection. So some Forge Lab cells, it's quite good, can hold double essence. Use that to get through the dungeons easier if you've got Shadowina's essences. And Wasper, that's one that I'm waiting to rank 5. I've got the cells, so now I've got exactly 40 cells over that to get to rank 5. Kinda just remembered that I think I should have been saving those tickets because the ancestors are gonna move into the general gate and they're gonna be easier to get. But it's worth it for the sake of a video. So that's the end of the PvP season as well. Gonna see what position I came in. 508 seconds. It's my best PvP season yet. 3 10 rune chests, 500 turtle marble cells, and an obsidian chest. I left it too late to do my relics opening video for the last relics experience boost, but I'm gonna do one soon. So those were pretty good summons from that season. Robur Oldenshield and Wolperdinger in the back. And I'm going to get round to hatching those other ones. Crafting the ones from the bounty hunt. So I've still got Velvet Dawn crafting. And I've got the Turkey Legend. Roasty crafting for some reason. I might make a action video if it's got a good action animation. So I didn't get too many purple lucky shots that had the Nephils there and a black baby on in them. So I'll need to buy that from the shop. Don't forget to spend your bounty coins the next few days after the season's ended. Remember to set your beast for your defense team in PvP, because it changes back to default as not having one set. Hope you enjoyed the video. Drop a like if you did. And I'll see you in another video. Until then, take it easy.